You've got your answers, so let me tell you what we think the answers are. Now, the nice thing about a decision tree, sort of conceptually and intuitively, is that it really is asking a series of questions. So we can simply look at these rows over here and the values that our features have, and we can just follow down the path of the tree. So in the first case, we have true. We have true for occupied, which means we want to go down the right side of the tree and check on the type. So in the first case, the type is pizza. And so we go down the first branch, and that means we do not go down the tree. So the output is no go.
So, okay, so now I got a different answer. So I looked at this and I said, happiness is true, and the bottom box says happiness true, you go.
Right, so you got the wrong. You got what I'm going to tell you is the wrong answer by going from the bottom of the tree up. The way decision trees work is you always start at the root of the tree. That is the very top of the tree, and you ask the questions in that order.
It just seems like it would be faster to start at the bottom.
Yeah, but then you would never look at anything else in the tree.
Good point. All right, so right?
If you start at the bottom, you can't go up.
All right. So, okay, so let me see if I get this straight. So I'll do this second instance. The second instance, you say that we need to start at the top of the tree where it says occupied. And so now I look at the instance, and the instance says that it's false for occupied. So we go down that left branch, and we hit no go. Oh, wait, but now I haven't looked at any of the other nodes.
Ah, and you don't have to look at any of the other nodes because it turns out that if it's not occupied, you just don't go into a restaurant. So you're the type of person who doesn't like to be the only person in a restaurant.
Got it. All right. So that's a no-go.
So that's a no-go. That's an important point, Michael. Actually, you might also notice that this whole tree, even if you look at every single feature in the tree, only has three of the attributes. It only looks at occupied, type, and happiness.
I see. So hot date is sort of irrelevant, which is good because in this case, it's not really changing from instance to instance anyway.
True. And neither is hungry, you might notice.
Oh, I am kind of hungry.
Although I'm always hungry. Although rainy does, in fact, change a little bit here and there. But apparently, it doesn't matter.
I see.
Because you always take an umbrella.
Got it.
Okay, so let's quickly do the other three and see if we come to the same conclusion.
All right. Well, all the instances that have occupied false, we know those are no-go right away.
Oh, good point.
So we can do it kind of out of order. And the other ones are both occupied. One is tie and one is other. For the tie one, we go. And for the other one, oh, I see. For the other one, we have to look at whether there's happiness or not. And in this instance, happiness is true. So we go down the right branch and we go.
And we go. Exactly it. So we noticed that hot date doesn't matter, hungry doesn't matter, and rainy doesn't matter. The only thing that matters are whether you're occupied, what type of restaurant you're at, and whether you're happy or not, or whether the patrons in the restaurants are happy or not. But here's the other thing about this. It's not just about the features. Let's tie it back into the other things that we mentioned in the beginning. This, in our case, this table actually represents our testing set. It's the thing that we're going to look at to determine whether we were right or wrong. These are the examples that we're going to do to see whether we generalize or not. And this particular tree here is our candidate concept. So there are lots and lots and lots of other trees that we might have used. We might have used a tree that also took asked questions about whether it was rainy or not, or asked questions about whether you were on a hot date or not, but we didn't. We picked a specific tree that had only these three features and only asked in this particular way. So what we're going to talk about next is how we might decide whether to choose this tree over any of the other possible number of trees that we might have chosen instead.